Hey folks, it's Josh, Stoney Rich Farmer. Welcome to the farm vlog today. Got my best good helper here. She's filling buckets of water. We're gonna go up and water the goats and check on them. Got a few chores to get done here around the house. I've got to put a light on my gate. So when folks pull up to my gate, I have a power gate that's powered with a Mighty Mule gate opener, and I really like it, but the biggest thing is we can hit the button from the house up here, but you can't tell whether the gate's moving or not after dark. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna install a motion light on it. And you guys might have seen the video where I installed some motion lights on the house back here, and they turned out to be really, really good. So come on along, we'll just do some chores here. We've got to work on the rock wall behind the house, got to pick up loads of rocks and sticks. And also, we still got the Stoney Ridge Farm shirts for a limited time. Mrs. Stoney Ridge is modeling one, you'll see them in the video. So if you want to get a shirt for a limited time only, there'll be links down in the video description, or you can go onto bonfire.com and search the word Stoney and you'll be able to find them. So let's go have some fun, all right? Woo!
Stoney Ridge Farm, Stoney Ridge. Stoney Ridge Farm.
So first, let's give you a little update on the lights, okay? So I put some lights here on the house. Now I'm in between my house and my garage. And I put these lights. They're called Litom brand. L-I-T-O-M. They really worked well. I liked them a lot. I put them all the way around the house. There's a couple up there. It's really bright. You probably can't see them. And I really liked them a whole lot. They really did a good job. And the company actually saw that I installed those lights. And they said, Stoney Ridge Farmer, we've got a newer version of that light. We'd like to send it to you and let you show it on the vlog. So here's the newer version. I've got the box with all the specs on it, but this is the light that we're going to put on the gate, and we're going to put one down here on this sign that I have posted that says smile, you're on camera. That way when people pull down my road, that thing lights up and they're like, ooh, maybe I shouldn't be here.
Got all the waters ready?
They're ready.
It's a mighty nice looking shirt you got there.
Well, thank you.
Self-promotion. It's not nice. It's not a nice thing to do on YouTube. Everybody hates that. Josh. So pretty out right now. So beautiful. We got some new rock put down on our road up to the goats, and it looks very nice. Very nice. Got a baby goat to catch, and we get to watch Mrs. Stoney Ridge catch it. You ready?
Let's do it.
Ready to catch him?
Let's do it.
Go ahead.
Okay, he wasn't very happy to cut in the bits. You're okay, see? Oh, goodness.
So is he better?
I think he's a little calmer.
A little better.
Poor little guy. He's okay.
Guys, you can see here that goats don't have any top teeth. No top teeth. Goats only have bottom teeth. The bigger issue we have here, guys, is we have too many goats in too small an area, and it's taxing on the goats, it's taxing on us, and we need to sell some goats. So if any of you guys are local and you're interested in buying some goats, we're gonna sell off probably 4, 5, 6 of them, something like that, because I think we're at about 20 goats right now, and we just don't need that many goats.
There we go.
Oh, chickens.
So we've got the ladder all loaded up in the back here, and we're gonna go down to the gate, and we're gonna install this light right here. So while the gate's closing here, here's the product that I'm installing. It's the Litom 30 LED motion light. This is what it looks like. Pretty neat little design there. So I'll post a link down below if you wanna get some for yourself. The other ones work great. I haven't used these yet, so I'll be honest with you. I don't know exactly how they're gonna work, but I know they're really bright because we used them in the living room as motion lights when we walked through the living room at night, and it worked really good. Let's get busy. So the challenge here is to mount this light somewhere on the back of this wooden sign, because I don't want to screw it into my metal gate. This thing will light up and let us know, hey, I hit the button, I'm up at the house, I hit the button and the gate started moving because the light came on, and I'll know. Trying to figure out the smartest way to mount this thing. So if you look, it's just a little loop, a little hook right there, and the screw is right here, and it just hangs on that screw. Pretty simple. We'll see. It doesn't have to be perfect. Just needs to be perfect. Timber! Dropping screws in the driveway is not a good thing. Okay, cool. We gotta turn it on. Here's how you turn it on. Little button right there. Gotta find that sweet spot. There we go. Now, so since it's on a moving target, I want to make sure it's nice and secure. You know, a moving target meaning the gate moves all the time. The mounting system on this is really, really, really simple. And I guess if you're mounting it up to the side of your house, it would be just fine, or a tree, which is what we're going to do next. I worry about it shaking loose and getting on my nerves and not being level and not being pretty. But I think that'll work. So we'll try it out tonight. I don't know if I'll try it out on camera tonight, but we'll let you know in future vlog how it's doing. I think it'll do just fine. So when you live in a country like this, we don't have a lot of neighbors, and people used to come down here and park. So before all the trees were gone right here, people would come down here and park and do things that they shouldn't be doing. And you know, people still ride down here from time to time that aren't welcome. So having some lights is probably the best security measure you could ever do around your house or around your farm or anywhere. Having lights, when those lights come on, criminals, they don't stick around. So right here's my fairly threatening smile you're on camera sign. If you guys didn't know it, Amazon's got a plethora, I would say a plethora of signs like this that are just threatening to keep people off your property. Signs that say closed circuit camera system, all sorts of stuff. And we've also got some cameras up here if you can see them. Let's see, right there. Yeah, so we've got some cameras up here. We keep track of everything that goes in the road and out of the road. So if you come down here on my property and something comes up missing, I got your license plate, bud. That's it. So let's back up to this tree. I'm just gonna back the gator right up to it. Good thing about the John Deere gator has this plastic bed, which, you know, plastic bed wouldn't really sound too appealing, but I can bump into something with it and not dent it. So that's kind of nice. We're gonna bump right into that tree. There we go. So for this next light install, we're gonna use a deck screw, a nice heavy duty deck screw. It'll just hang up there just like that. Pretty simple. Right there. Thing of beauty. Cool. Just that simple. Just that simple to install. Super awesome. That'll illuminate that sign right there. And we got the sign kind of flopping loose so this tree can grow a little bit. And I also left a little bit of room for tree growth on that screw. I left it hanging out a little bit further. Got my own little Department of Homeland Security here. Thing about living out here in the country like this is when seconds count, the cops get here in minutes. We got to pretty much defend ourselves and take care of ourselves out here. Beautiful, beautiful day today, guys. The grass that we planted in the fall is coming up so pretty. Look at this. Look at that. What a great stand of grass. We did all the right things. Only thing we could have done differently is the soil is really acidic here, so we probably could have put a little bit of lime down. But once the soil gets compacted a little bit, we'll be able to bring a big lime truck in here and we'll spread lime, probably 3 tons to the acre, maybe even 4 tons of lime to the acre. So this is what you call a lead-in to tomorrow's vlog. So I've got 2 more loads of gravel coming out. I had 5 loads brought out, and this is the result of the gravel truck. I'll get the drone out and I'll show you a little bit of tractor work here on the driveway and give you a little bit of driveway science if you want to know a little bit about how to maintain and keep a nice driveway. So 32 more tons of rock brought out tomorrow, and I want to expand this a little bit. As you can tell, I got a lot of vehicles. I want to be able to come through here with a big old trailer and turn around and not have any trouble. Last hole I'm gonna drill. My dogs are out here eating deer turds, like grazing on deer turds right now. The puppy loves to poop on the porch at night, so we keep them up on the porch at night. Since my dogs ate my neighbor's cat, we keep them up on the porch at night. And I just totally look forward to cleaning up doggy diarrhea later on, because there are 20 something deer every night in this field, and they're out there, the dogs are out there grazing on deer poo. There's your farm reality right there. Dogs grazing on deer poo. You know, it's not a good job unless you're bleeding when you get done. So hopefully I'll have some blood drawn here in a minute. Ah, little piece of heaven right there. I got my light. These lights are so small I can put them in my pocket. Really nice. Boom. A little bit loose. We'll tighten it back up a little bit. There we go. Nice. Nicely done. The solar panels are right here. This is west. This is south. So it'll get just enough sun, and then when I walk in here to access my tractor and everything like that, I'll be able to see. So we're going to do another one just like this on the other side. That's it. We'll give you an example of what it looks like lit. So that's the light. That's how much light this thing puts out. I think it's 30 LED lights in there. Very nice. Danger. Bush hog danger right there. That thing was sticking out of the ground. Yeah. If you go to clear land, this is the kind of stuff that you're going to be finding. When you clear your land, people just used any old gully as just a dumping ground. And cinder block pieces, Pepsi, is that Pepsi free? This is what you find, just garbage. So there's a lot of garbage out here. It's a shame. Back in the day, people didn't go to the dump and people didn't have trash service. They had a hole. And that's what they did. They threw it in there. I bet some of you folks remember Grandma's old hole we used to throw all the trash in. Post me a comment down there.
Thank y'all.
She's picking up the heaviest, biggest rock she can find. Tell her, get the little ones and I'll get the big ones. She's not listening. She's not listening. Stubborn. Springtime's here. We're gonna start planting soon. So look forward to that, getting our garden veggies all planted up in the house, you know, getting them started. And then come about April 20th is when we'll put them in the ground. That's probably the last frost date that we'll have up here. And that'll be cool. We'll get some things going. Guys, don't forget, we got the Stoney Ridge Farm shirts. They're here for a limited time only. I think they're only available for 15 more days or maybe 12 more days. Jump on it, get you a shirt if you want one. If you don't want one, don't worry about it. All right. Thanks a lot, guys. Come on back and see us here on the farm. Sure enjoyed having you. We'll see you next time, all right? Woo!
Well, come on down to the Stoney Ridge. Bring your wife and bring your kids. We're living life pure and sweet. That's the way it's supposed to be, Stoney Ridge.
Thanks a lot for watching us today, guys. We'll see you next time on the Stoney Ridge Farm. We appreciate it. Subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed, and you can watch the farm grow with us. Take care.